Good morning, students. The next concept is regarding the interface under the module 4, packages, interfaces and multi-threaded program. So let us see the definition of interface. Now, before defining the interface, you should know why the concept of interface has come. What is the application of interface? Now, when you have already seen the concept of inheritance, you have learned regarding the various forms of inheritance, but you know the drawback is in Java it doesn't support multiple inheritance. That is, class in Java cannot have more than one superclass. So that was one drawback which we had seen in the concept of the inheritance. So that we know that Java doesn't support the multiple inheritance. So to overcome this drawback, interfaces were introduced. That is nothing but so that it was possible by interfaces to support the concept of multiple inheritance. Okay, so Java class cannot be a subclass of more than one superclass. You know, Java class cannot be a subclass of more than one superclass. That is, class A extends B extends C. It's not possible. So it could be done possible by the interface. It could be done possible by the interface. So this was a major major advantage of the interface, where actually the picture of interface came. Okay, now let us come back to the definition of the interfaces. So what is happening in the interfaces is, it is basically a kind of class itself. It is basically a kind of class itself. You know, within the class you have the data members and the methods. Same way, interface also has data members and the methods. Like class, interface also contains methods and variable, but with a major difference. Now, what is that major difference? The major difference is, the interface defines only the abstract methods and the final field. Okay, it will what does it mean, abstract methods and the final fields? It tells that interface do not specify any code to implement these methods. Now, for example, if I tell interface callback, example, just you have to use the keyword interface and then you should give the name for the interface within that. Now, for example, I'll just tell interface, let it be interface. I'll just show you over here. Okay, I'll just show you interface callback. So I defined over here, callback is the name of the interface and interface is the keyword. Within this, I can declare, I can only do the prototyping. I can only use the abstract methods, and the data fields are always final fields. Final, here I have just one function, students. I have just one function. Other than that, for example, I can like final int n equal to 10. So what is happening? What do you mean by final? You're going to already set the value and you're not going to change that particular value. Okay, so here this can be either a final, it can be a final and a static. Variables can be declared inside the interface and they're implicitly final and static, meaning that they cannot change the values in the implementing class. Okay, so this is regarding the interface definition, what I told. So the thing is, it is similar to the class. It is similar to the class, where in class you could also define the methods. You could define the methods and you can declare the variables. Okay, here the difference is, it defines only the abstract method. That's what I told, only the abstract. That means only the declaration is there in the within the interface, but the definition is implemented somewhere else. Okay, and the variables, whatever we declared, is it is final fields. Okay, it is final fields. That means they are constants. You cannot change anything. Okay, so that is regarding what exactly the interface contains. Now we'll go to the syntax of the interface. So access, you can specify the access whatever you want, public or private or default or protected, whatever the access specifier you want, you can specify. But when there is no access specifier, that means it is a default interface. Okay, that means it is a default interface. And it's, what do you mean by default? Default means it is visible to the only the other members of the package. Other members of the same package. So you know, if you declare public, it's visible to all. Okay, so this is regarding the access specifier, then the interface keyword and the name, and here whatever the return type, method name, parameter list, that's what I told. Abstract methods are defined over here, and then final variable name with the valuable, final whatever the in final variable name with the values over here. Okay, values over here. So this is regarding the data members, and this is regarding the methods you are going to define over here. So just remember, it contains abstract methods and the final field. So this is the syntax. So over here, So this is a general example I would like to tell. So int final, whatever the variable you want to define, you can define over here. Int final, whatever the variable name with the assigned value, you can define over here. And within this interface, I have just one function called void callback within that int param. Okay, interface callback. Name is callback is the name of the interface, and I did not specify any access specifier, so default it is, and interface is the keyword. Within this, I did not define any data member. I just called one function, that is void callback int param. Now this is what you have created, the interface, right? Now how you are going to implement this particular function? So implementing the interface is the next concept. Once an interface is defined, now already you had seen in the previous slide, I just defined an interface with the name callback. Within that, I have the function void callback. So once an interface has been defined, one or more classes can implement that interface. Okay, one or more class can implement that interface. To implement an interface, that is to implement this particular interface, includes the implement clause. This is the syntax here. Whatever your new class you're going to create, class, for example, class name is, let it be like sample, class sample. If you have extend superclass, that's fine. If not, that is an optional. This is an optional. Implements whatever the interface. What was our interface? Callback. Okay, extends superclass, that is also fine. If not, class name, this is an option. Like you can give class sample, extends b, implements interface, like interface name it is, interface implements callback, comma callback one also you can give. Within that, whatever that function is there, that you're going to define over there. Okay, so that is regarding, this is what he is telling. To implement an interface, include the implements clause in a class definition, and then create the methods defined by the interface. Now, whatever the method you're called here, right, that you're going to void callback, that you're going to define within this interface. Now, for example, let me come over here. Example class that implements the callback interface. So, you know, callback interface I have called, interface callback, within that had void callback. So here I created a class client which implements that particular callback. What does it mean? Whatever the method within the callback is done, is implemented by this particular class client. So within this, I'm calling that void public callback int p. Then I'm printing callback, whatever the function definition is there, I'm going to do here. Callback called with plus p. So that's what he is telling regarding the syntax. Class, class name. For example, here it is class client implements. This is optional, okay? If you have an super class, you can tell like class client extends manager implements callback. You can also have. If not, it is separated by comma. Again, if you're using two interface, callback comma callback one, and whatever the methods of your interface is defined over here, okay, is defined over here. It can also execute its own methods. In addition to that, whatever the methods is defined by the interface should be defined over here. If a class interface more than one interface, the interfaces are separated with comma. That's what I told. If one class, for example, this class itself, class client implements callback. If you want to implement one more interface, for example, callback one, then it is separated by callback one, and you're going to write over here callback one. So that is regarding the how you are going to do the implementation of the interface. So in short, once an interface has been defined, we have defined over here, you need one or more class that can implement the interface. To implement the interface, this implement clause is very important, and the class implement interface definitions of those methods are defined within this particular class. The general form is this, and if you have two or more interfaces that is being used by the one particular class, then it is separated by the comma. Okay, then that is separated by comma. And also remember the very important point, the methods that you implement, I mean the methods of these, right, whatever of interface you're going to implement in the different class, always you're going to tell it is a public. You're going to use the, must be declared as public there, not here, there. Okay, wherever you're going to do the definition of this particular method within some class that implements this particular interface, then you're calling it as public always. This is a mandatory. Okay, the method that implement an interface must be declared public. So this is a simple example which showed continuation of this interface callback, void callback, int param. So here, class client is my new class which implements the callback. Implements is the clause I'm going to use over here. Implement is the clause I'm going to use over here. And then I define that callback prototype, what I've defined within abstract method, whatever I defined within the callback interface. So it is public void callback int p, system out.println callback called with p. So this is a simple example. So over here, implement one example, that is just implementing this within this. Next example is implement interfaces to define additional members of their own. Now what we saw is within this class I just implemented the callback method of the interface callback. In addition, if this class has some more methods, right, to implement, if this particular class client has his own methods, then those methods also can be added over here. This is of interface, this is method of interface, his own methods also can be implemented. So that's what is shown over here. Implement interfaces to define additional members of their own. Now here, class client implements callback. Same I took, class client implements callback, and then I called the callback function of the, then I called the callback function of the interface, public void callback, same what you have seen. This is there, right, void non-iface is, it is a method definition of this particular class itself. It is a method definition of this particular class client. So this, you can also, he is telling, you can also define their own members, their own methods, okay. It is possible to define their own methods over here. So this is a simple example. So within this, you just have classes that implement interfaces may also have defined other methods too, other members too. Just a printf statement to understand the concept. Now let us run these interface. Same, I have done the copy of combined the program and written one example one and example two. So let me see the example one. So here in the example one, I defined interface callback, and within that I just put a prototype abstract method void callback, within that int param, integer value I'm going to send, and then I wrote my class which will implement this particular interface. So within that I defined this particular function. So I told, when you define the abstract methods within other class interface abstract methods, you should always use public. So public void callback int p, then system out.print call, whatever that parameter you pass, that will be printed, callback called with whatever the value, then this method is of your class. So I printed class system out.println class that implements interface may also define other members too. So this is the value. So this is the value, and then just a main, public static void main string args. Then what I did is, now here I'll tell you the major difference, but now you just understand. I created an object of class, I mean sorry, interface callback, callback C, but it's accessing, it's why we are going to use the new, to instantiate the class, we create an instance of each class by using the new operator. So your new class is what, client. So you should write new callback inter, whatever the callback is your interface, its object is C, but I'm going to instantiate the class client. Now what is happening, the client object is being created, okay. Your interface C is assigned to the instance of the client. So c callback 42 when you call, it will go to this callback, and that method is defined over here, just this callback method will be called, but not this. I'll tell why it is not in the next example, why it is not called with this particular, why this method is not called in the next example, I'll just tell you. Now I called with c.callback42. So callback's object is being created. C is a callback's object which will be accessing, which will create an instance of the client, and memory is being created for the client, okay. And then I called c.callback42. When I call callback42, it will just go to this particular and execute callback42. This function will be executed, okay. I'll tell why, what is the difference, I'll tell while doing the execution. I'll just let you know. So let us run this particular program in the NetBeans. So here test interface, same code. void callback interface, then only abstract method, then implements callback over there to its own, then callback C and this. So I'll just run this particular program. So you can see callback is been called, right? 42 value is been passed. So callback called with 42. So this function would call, when you call this C dot callback, it would call this, and then its definition is over here. Definition is over here, so it will call and print this particular statement. Is it clear? So this is regarding a simple example. Only confusion is you're going to create interface object that is accessing the instance of the client class. So obviously this is accessing the client class. Method definition is in the client class, so it is accessing the client, but it is only accessing the callback function. See, because you called only callback, you can see this is small c, so it will call only that particular callback function. Now let us go to the example 2. Same example, slight changes is there. I'll let you know what is the slight changes. Your interface callback, same example what you've seen in the example 1, void callback int, interface callback, it had only one abstract method. Then class client implements callback, it had callback and non-iface meth. So this is nothing but its own method, it is being defined. Next you have another client, okay, class another client implements callback. Class another client implements callback. So what was there in callback? You had abstract method callback. So here another version of callback, and he's telling p squared is, he just wrote another version. So you know, right, whenever you tell implements callback, then obviously whatever the method is defined within this whatever the prototype is defined, abstract method is being told over there, that should be defined over here. Okay, so I wrote system.out.println another version of callback, and println p squared is p into p. For example, 42 in, if I send 42 into 42. Now this is another, okay, now what I did is public static void main, then callback c is equal to new client, same I called, just these two are same of your previous example. Next what I did is another client object ob, new another client, I mean I created another client object of this particular class, another client object I created, you know how, using the new operator I did the instance of this particular class, another client. Now I call c dot callback 42. When I call c dot callback 42, it will just call only the callback function. Then what I did is C now refers to another client object. Whatever this object is there, whatever this object memory has been allocated, right, that is stored in the C. Now anymore this object will act as C. Now I call c dot callback 42. Now what is the difference is, when I call callback C new client, and then I call c dot callback 42, that will just call this, callback called with 42. Okay, when I just called c dot callback, same like previous, when I did this another client object is equal to new another client, this object then I passed to the interface, and through this interface object again I call the callback 42. When I call that callback 42, what it will do, what is having object, now object is referring to this particular interface, I mean this particular class, another client. Agree? Why? Because this object is of this particular class and that is stored in this. When you call that c dot callback 42, it will come this and it will implement all the functions here. This callback function will be implemented, that is another version of callback, and p squared is equal to whatever this is be defined. Now what is the point you need to remember over here is, we created an instant of each class using the new operator. Okay, here it is assigned to the instance of the client, C is assigned to the instance, but it is interface object. Remember, this is an interface, this is a class, and this is a class. Here it is an interface object is assigned to the instance of the client. Okay, next what we did, then we declare an object type of interface callback so it can access the callback method. I created this callback object so that I can access the callback method. Agree? I can access the callback method, but it could not access the iface method. You know, it could not access the iface method. Okay, that you have to remember. And then since it is defined by the client but not iface, I mean it is being defined by the client, but not by the iPhase, I mean not by the interface callback, since it is defined by the client but not by but not callback interface. So it is just callback via call. Now to implement a method, we need to refer. See here, this is what you might get confused. To implement a method, what we are going to do is we need to refer to the class objects. See here, we need to refer to the class objects as type of the interface, as type of the interface, rather than the type of their respective classes, rather than the type of the respective classes. So what I did is I created an object of the class, and then I referred to, see, now refers to the another client object, then through this, I mean interface object itself, I am going to call the method. That's what he is telling, not through the class, not through the class. So we need to refer to the first we need to refer to the class objects, then again we are going to store it in the interface, then we are going to call it again through the interface objects, rather than by the type of their respective classes. Got it? So this is the difference I just wanted to tell you. So this is regarding, rather than calling through this ob dot, no, we are calling it through the interface c dot callback 42. When c dot call dot 42, this function, I mean this method will be executed. So let us just run this particular program and check. So same test iPhase 2, this is a program, same program itself, only these two functions are same program I've called, only these two functions, I mean this method, and here slight changes for this and this and this. So when it calls c dot callback, it will go to this, first is c back callback 42, right? So it will go to this callback function and it will print. Next it is calling c dot callback 42 again, but it is, we are going to create, since we are storing OB within the C, that means it is going to call for this particular class method. Okay, so just we'll run this particular program and check. You can see callback called with 42, our first output for this, and then C dot callback 42, within that C back another version of callback P squared is 42 into 42. So this is regarding the execution of the interface. So I hope it's clear with this example. Next is regarding the partial implementation. Now what they're telling within the partial implementation is, for example, you have a class. Okay, I'll go back over here itself. I'll just tell you, you have a class client over here, implements callback, but you don't define the definition of the interface method. For example, you know, in the, within the callback interface, you add this method, right? This method. If you don't define this method within the class that implements the interface, then it is called partial interface. Then it is called, if a class includes an interface, he is telling implements, see here, class incomplete. Incomplete is the name of the class. It implements callback, but does not fully implement the methods defined by that interface, then the class must be declared as abstract. Here you are going to tell abstract, and here you see we have not defined anything of that void callback method, we did not define. So this is called the concept of partial implementation. Next concept is regarding the nested interface. Now what do you mean by nested interface? Is nothing but an interface can be declared as a member of a class. For example, class A, within this you're going to define your interface, within this you're going to define an interface. So nested interface is nothing but an interface defined under a class, or it may be defined under another interface. For example, you write interface syntax whatever A, and here you write interface B. Okay, interface B. So an interface can be declared as a member of a class, or it can also be declared as a member of another interface. Such an interface is called nothing but nested interface. And a nested interface, you can again define the access as public, private, or protected. So this is a simple example for the nested interface, but which is a nested interface example, but where interface is defined within the class. As I told, you can define within the class, also you can define within the another interface. So this is a simple example where your interface is defined within the class. Interface is defined within the class. So let us see this example. Package nested info, okay, and then class A. So this is a class A, this is a nested interface. If you have one more interface, so your public interface nested in, so you can see your interface as public, interface is a keyword, and the name of the interface is nested if. Within there, within this I have one function declaration, abstract method that is being defined. You know that here in within the interface it is just the method and final variables. We don't define those methods. Those methods are implemented in some other class which will implement this particular interface. So your class B is implementing this interface. So if you're implementing this interface, you know this is within the class. So A dot nested if is written over here, dot operator. B implements the nested interface. So nested interfaces are separated by class name dot the interface name. If it was an interface here, interface A, even then it would be interface whatever the name is there. For example, instead of class you had interface sample one, then it would be sample one dot nested if. That is the only difference, okay? That is the only difference. So class B implements a dot nested if. Within this class B, right, I'm defining this particular function. So what is that function? Public boolean is not negative index. Some integer values I'm going to pass and I'm going to check whether it is a boolean or not. I mean, whether it is a not negative, positive or negative, whether it is a positive or negative. So what is happening? Return X, whatever the value is sent, I'm using the question mark operator. X, if it is true, then this will be executed. If it's false, this should be executed. Agree? I mean, X tends to, if it is X less than 0, false will be taken. If it is X less than not 0, then true would be taken. Agree? If this was true, then this would execute. If this was false, then this would execute. You know this operator, how it works. So this is the function, and then I call public class nested if demo. Within that I define the main, and then you know using the interface I created an object which is actually fetching the instead of the class B. So a dot nested if nif new B. Now I'm going to call this particular function. If this object nif dot is not negative, I pass 10. If this is true, whatever this value is true, then this would be printed. If this was false, then this wouldn't print. So I called twice. See here, I created using the nested interface, that is class name dot nested, you know, a dot nested if, that's object I created, nif. Why not nested if? Because here it is within the class. So a dot nested if nif is equal to newbie is going to be created. After that I call the function. If object name dot whatever the function is not negative of 10, so it would come over here, is not negative of 10, come over here. So it will check whether 10 is less than 0. No, it is not less than 0, so it will not execute this. Instead it will return true. Yes, it is true, that's why 10 is not negative. It will come and print this particular statement. Next I have written if not negative of -12, so it will come to -12. So -12 less than 0, true. So that way this expression will execute first, false will be written. If false, this would not execute itself. So this is regarding the program logic. So let us just run this particular program in the here. So here the example is nested if demo, same program, same logic. I'll just run. So you can see 10 is not negative will be printed. This would result with false. So this is not printing only, this won't be displayed itself. I have written over there. So just the 10 is not negative will be printed. So this is regarding the concept of nested interface. So as I told, you can define an interface within the class. If not, you can define within the interface itself. But when you call or define anywhere, implements you call, you're separating by the dot. And even when you create an object, you're going to separate with the dot. Okay, such an interface is called nested interface, and they can be declared as public, private or protected. Okay, next we'll see the concept of variables in interface. How you're going to create a variables in interface. So we'll come back to this theoretical part later. So this is how you have created an interface shared constant. So these all are the shared constant. I mean, these are the final variables which has some values and it cannot be changed. Okay, no, yes, maybe, later, soon, and these I've set, I've defined. So here what is it telling? In the sense, you can use interface to import shared constant into multiple classes. These are the these are the nothing but import shared constant. So if you written over here, if you see, I'm going to import the shared constant. That means static. These all are the variables of the static which cannot be changed as a final. And also I've defined the random. These things I told, right, regarding within the package, you can use import and you can call those things. So random also I'm using, as well as the shared constant I'm going to use. So here I've used import shared constant into multiple classes by simply declaring an interface, and that constant variables are initialized to desired values. So these are the constant variables, they are initialized to the desired values within the interface, interface name and this. Okay, so that's what I've written over here. You can use interfaces to import shared constant into multiple classes by simply declaring an interface that contains variable that are initialized to the desired value. When you include the interfaces in a class, that is when you implement the interface, all of those variables names will be in the scope as constant, as final variables. For example, you write, right, as define max 3. So maximum is only 3 for the stack size you write, right? So that's why same way I have defined here. Okay, if an interface contain no method, then any class that includes such an interface does not actually implement anything. If it doesn't contain anything, any method, if it doesn't contain any method over here, then it's not going to implement anything. Instead, it's going to use only these variables as the final variables, as final variables. So this is an interface with these all variables. So we'll see what will happen. Class question is my question, which will implement this particular interface. That means he is going to use these variables. Okay, but the values will be the constant. They are taken as a final. We cannot modify these values. Okay, then he called the int task method. In that, what is happening, he stored int prob probability. Okay, it is nothing but the probability, and then he typecasted that whatever this result to int. Now what is this? Your rand.next double is nothing but randomly I imported java.util.random, right? So it will send some random numbers, any integer values it can send. Since I have called within the rand, I have called next double, so it will call from 0.0 to next double will call to 0.0 to 1.0. Between this, right, next double will have the value 0.0 to 1.0. So it will call any number, any double number. Rand.double means any number between this. For example, it might call 0.5. For example, it might call 0.5. So you know 100 into 0.5 is nothing but 50. Agree? Half of this 100, 50, typecasted to int. So 50 will be stored. Int prob is 50. If 50 is less than 30, then it would go work with this return. Else if 50 is less than 60, it would return yes. Yes, in our case it is yes. So it would return yes. Same way it would go and execute. Now if you take something like 0.2, that would result 80. Yes or no? When you tell, for example, randomly the numbers are generated. When you tell random, right, it is, what is the job of random is, randomly the numbers are generated. So this provides pseudo random numbers. Okay, so for example, if I tell 0.2 is randomly generated. So if you 0.2 into 100 would give me what? 20. 0.2 into 100 would give me 20. 0.2 into 100 will be 20. So it is less, so it would return no. 0.5 into 100 would give me 50. So it would have written this. So that's what I have told. Randomly the number will generate. So randomly that will get written. So this is regarding what is happening within the question. Okay, coming back to ask, class ask me implements same interface. Here what I told is static void answer. This is a function. I called a switch called result. I have declared a result over here. I result. If it is case no, if it is returns no over there. Now for example, it returned no for for 0.2. Then it would tell that println no. If it return yes, it would return yes. Whatever that statements were there, those were written. And then what I did, I called four time ask. I'll tell you what is happening here. Question Q, why I called question, using the class itself, because in the interface there is no method. That's why I created a question Q. Here, this class ka question queue object, class object, new question. And using this object, I call this particular function ask. Okay, I call this particular for ask. And that ask I've sent as a parameter for this here. Whatever that result I got it from here, right? Whatever the result I got it from here, I'm sending it as a parameter, right? So case no, case yes, all those things. So that I've sent over here, that I've sent over here. So q.ask, what will q.ask return me? q.ask will return no or yes or anything. So that if I send no over here, then this will be printed. So for that I have passed. So totally how many times I have called? 4 times I have called. So this is regarding how the program works with the variable constants, with the variable constants. So variables in the interface. So let us just run this program. Okay. Now shade constants. So here what I did is I called this particular program. Answer 4 times I called. So 4 times randomly the outputs will be generated. Okay, randomly. I'll tell each time it will differ. Why? I'll tell you. q.ask. So first it will go to the ask, it will perform, it will return yes, no, maybe, later, soon, never, and for this answer it will send, and that statement will be printed. So I'll run this particular file. See, we'll run once, first time. So soon, no, soon it came. What is happening, you know, we'll compare. Soon, no, soon it came. What is happening? By using this Java util.random, okay, random double integers are coming. So sometimes it may come 0.1, 0.1, 0.1 only. It is between what I told you, right? It is between 0.0 to 0.0 to 1.0. Right? I mean, it is between 0 to 1.0. So randomly, it might call 0.1, 0.1, 0.1 itself. So for example, it called 0.1. So in example, it will call 0.1. What would happen? 0.1 into 100 would give me what result? 10. Again, it would call 0.1. 10. Again, it would call 0.1, 10. So what is happening? No is coming, and no itself is being printed. So 4 times I called random. It is pseudo random. Any number can be repeated or any number may be called. So each time when you call, the output will be different. See here. Last time you got soon. Now you got no. Now again I'll run. You can check here. See. Later, soon, later. So each time it will differ. So this will return you the whatever the answer no, and this will be sent as a parameter in the next class, and then it will print. Printf is happening over here. No, yes, maybe. So this I actually called 4 times. Since interface doesn't have any method, using the class I create an object q, and that q.ask is called within the answer. So what is happening? This q.ask will return actually whether it is soon or yes, no, later, never, and that will send as a parameter. If that sent parameter, this is being executed. So this is regarding the variables. Next is regarding the cons. Very important is interfaces can also be extended. They can also be extended. Now what is happening here? What is the concept? One interface can inherit another by use of the keyword extend. You can see here, this is an interface that has been defined. Okay, A. Within this I called void method 1, void method 2. So you know, interface is a keyword, name of the interface is A, and then I called two abstract method. Now I defined interface B, which extends interface A. There I defined void method 3. Now what is happening? It now includes method 1, method 2, it adds method 3. This, are you getting? So this is the concept of one interface can inherit another by use of the keyword extend. The syntax is same as for your inheriting classes. Okay, when a class implements an interface, here you can see class my class implements an interface. Okay, when a class implements an interface that inherits another interface, it must provide implementation for all the methods defined within the interface inheritance. Now, for example, when I tell public class my class implements B, so it should implement method 3, method 1, method 2 also. That's what he is telling. So this is regarding the concept of interface can be extended. So let me explain this program. Package if extend, interface A, void method 1, void method 2. Okay, void method 1, void method 2. This is defined over here. Then interface B extends A, void method 3. Here what is happening? It is inheriting method 1, method 2. Now when you define, this is also an abstract. When you going to define these, all these methods, so that should define all these methods. Now whatever that implementation is done. So this class, my class, must implement all of A and B. That's what he is telling. Okay, so I define method 1, printf. Implemented method 1, void method 2, implemented method 2, a print statement, void method 3, implement. So here I called, see, my class, I called the object of my class, Okay, you can also call using the interface. I called using my class object. And then why I did not call interface, because in this interface it's only two method. Okay, so again here it is three method. So I called my class object, new my class, and then I called object dot method 1, object dot method 2, object dot method 3. Okay, I called this particular class and then I defined all these methods. So this is regarding the interfaces can be extended. So let me run this same program. Let me just run. So same code is being written. I'll run over here. So you can see implement method 1, implement method 2, implemented method 3. So what is happening? Interface had two methods. So this interface methods I could inherit by using the keyword extend, interface B extend A, then void method. So these all three methods are defined within this. So class, my class implements B I have written because it has been there. And then the main, within the main, again through the my class object, I defined object 1 dot method 1, object dot 2 method 2, object 3 object dot method 3. So this is regarding the execution of the interfaces can be extended. So overall concept we had seen regarding the interfaces, regarding how to define an interface, what is the advantage of interface. As I told, Java had a drawback of multiple inheritance, whereas by using interface I can implement any method of any method. I can just write abstract method and then I can define any method through the some other class. So that was the advantage. And then we had seen what is the syntax, then how we are going to implement an interface, even if it has an additional members. Then we had seen regarding variables, nested interface. Okay, we had seen regarding the variables, nested interface, and then interface can be extended. So this is the overall concepts of the interface. Thank you.